It was the summer of 1996 in Abilene, Texas, and a man by the name of Brian Bethel was sitting in his car at a local strip mall, filling out a check by the light of the nearby movie theater marquee. He was about to go slip this check through the after-hours Dropbox at his internet service provider's office, because believe it or not, back in the 90s, that's how you had to pay for internet access. He had just finished signing his name and was about to get out of his car when he heard a faint tapping at the window. Brian looked up, and to his surprise, two boys in dark hoodies were standing by the window. One was taller with dark curly hair and tan skin, and the other was a little shorter with very pale skin and red hair. Brian estimated they were between 8 and 12 years old. The older boy motioned for Brian to roll down the window, and he obliged, asking the two boys what was wrong. The older boy explained that he and his brother had come to see the last showing of the Mortal Kombat movie, but that they'd left the house without any money for tickets. The movie was going to start soon, and they didn't have time to walk, so the boys wanted to know if Brian would quickly give them a ride home so they could get the money from their mom. Immediately, Brian felt something was off. As a journalist, he'd had to interview a few children for local news stories, and he found that most children were hesitant to speak to adults they didn't know. But for some reason, these boys had no fear about asking a stranger for help. They seemed too confident, almost like they had rehearsed what they were saying, and Brian couldn't shake the feeling that something sinister was going on. The older boy seemed to sense this unease in Brian, saying to him, "We're just two little kids. It's not like we have a gun or anything." Despite the fact that Brian was not reassured by this statement at all, he still found himself reaching for the lock on his car door. Even though it was a bad idea, and he knew it, he found himself compelled, as if by some outside force, to open the doors and let these two boys in. Brian looked back at the two boys, and by the dim light in the parking lot, he saw that something was very wrong with them. It was their eyes. Neither boy had any visible irises or whites to their eyes. Their eyes were solid black. Brian would later describe them as soulless orbs, like two great swaths of starless night. The boys were aware that Brian had noticed, and the older one, who was doing most of the talking, became even more pushy with his request. "You have to let us in," he said. "We can't come in unless you let us, so let us in." Completely freaked out at this point, Brian rolled up his window and drove off, leaving his internet bill unpaid until the next day. While this might sound like a creepypasta, Brian's story is terrifyingly true. And when he finally posted his tale online, he would become the first person to record an encounter with creatures that would come to be known as black-eyed kids. Black-eyed kids can be any race or gender, but they always appear to be between the ages of 6 and 16. They usually dress in hoodies, but there are many reports of them wearing noticeably old-fashioned clothes. Aside from their solid black eyes, there never seems to be anything physically abnormal about them, but witnesses often describe feeling an intense uneasiness or dread while interacting with them, even before they notice their eyes. Black-eyed kids most often show up at night, though they have been seen during the day, and they usually travel in pairs. Typically, one kid will do the talking while the other stays silent. A typical black-eyed kid encounter will involve the kids asking for something that normally involves coming into the home or vehicle of whoever they're speaking to. Usually, this is under the pretense of needing to use the phone or the bathroom. Because of their insistence on being let in, many have theorized that black-eyed kids may be a type of vampire, while others believe that they're some kind of human-alien hybrids or demons, and there's some other mysterious and terrifying reason why they must be invited in. As for what happens when the kids get what they want, very few accounts exist from people who have let the black-eyed kids in, and some have cited that as proof that you won't live to tell the tale if you do. One sighting took place in 2012 at a gas station in Louisiana and was recounted to the host of the show Darkness Radio 3 years later in 2015. The person telling the story was a man who worked at the gas station, which was the only one for miles on a lonely stretch of highway. It was 3 a.m. and the power had just gone out. The man navigated his way to the backup generator and switched it on. But strangely, only the lights over the parking lot and register lit up. The rest of the shop was still enveloped in darkness. The man looked out into the now lit up parking lot and noticed three children riding up to the station on their bikes. As he looked at them, two of the children, one boy and one girl, hopped off their bikes and headed for the door. Concerned, the man went to open the door and asked the children what was wrong. After all, it wasn't normal to see young kids riding their bikes around at 3 a.m. The girl asked him if she could use his phone, and he handed her his cell phone. She refused to take it, pointing to the landline behind the cash register and saying, "No, I need the real phone." The man looked at the phone and then back at the girl, and that was when he noticed both she and her companion had solid black eyes. Terrified, he slammed the door closed and locked it, telling the girl that she and her friends had to go home. They stared at him for a moment before turning around and getting back on their bikes to leave. The next day, the man told his boss what happened, but unfortunately, due to the power failure, the security cameras hadn't captured any evidence of this strange encounter. Another black-eyed kid encounter was reported by Lee Brickley, a paranormal investigator who spoke to a woman in Kenneck Chase, England, in 2014. The woman had been out with her daughter when they heard a child screaming nearby. Concerned that a child might be in danger, the woman went searching until she found a little girl in a white dress who had her hands over her eyes. The woman asked the little girl what was wrong and where her parents were. The girl took her hands away from her eyes, and the woman realized the girl's eyes were solid black. Frightened, the woman grabbed her own child and ran away. Brickley was initially interested in this story because his aunt had once described a similar encounter in 1982, over a decade before Brian Bethel's encounter sparked interest in black-eyed kids. Brickley's aunt reported a similar experience. She saw a little girl in white walking around by herself, and when she tapped the girl on the shoulder to ask if she was lost, the girl turned to her, revealing black eyes. The black-eyed girl from Kenneck Chase has been spotted multiple times, and in 2015, she was even allegedly captured on amateur drone footage. On Reddit, a user posted about a terrifying black-eyed kid encounter they'd had when they were still themselves just a child. It happened on March 17, 2008, when they were 12 years old. They were sitting in the car outside of a hairdresser, waiting for their mother's appointment to finish, when they saw someone they thought was one of their classmates. They started banging on the window to get their attention, but when the boy turned to them, they realized it was a stranger. The Reddit user said, "The boy walks over to the side of my car and just stares. I think to let me get a good look at his eyes, to freak me out. Let me tell you, if you have never seen a black-eyed kid, you have no idea what to imagine. Pupils black as the night sky." The boy demanded to be let into the car, scaring the 12-year-old so much that they ducked under the seats. When their mother returned to the car, she told them that, while she'd been in the salon, something strange had happened. A boy with black eyes had come in, but that wasn't all. The strange child had tried to take her car keys. One of the only stories of a person actually letting black-eyed kids into their home comes from Vermont in January 2016. A blizzard was raging outside, and a married couple were sitting in their front room together when they heard a knock at the door. Thinking it might be someone who had crashed their car in the snow or gotten stranded and needed help, the wife jumped up to answer the door. When she did, she saw two children standing on her porch. One boy and one girl, who both looked about 8 years old and didn't seem to be dressed for the weather. Immediately worried for their safety, the woman brought them inside and sat them down on the couch. Looking back on the event, the woman said, "It was around 2 o'clock in the morning at this point, so the only reasonable thought in my head was that there must have been an accident or these kids got lost. As much as my instincts told me not to bring them inside, I did it anyway." The first strange thing she noticed about the children was that her cats hissed at them as she brought them into the room. Ignoring the warning signs from her felines, the woman asked the two children if they wanted some hot chocolate to warm them up. They declined the offer, saying that their parents would be there soon. The woman found it strange that they seemed so sure their parents were coming there, since they hadn't even asked to use the phone. The woman went to fetch the children their hot drinks, and when she returned to hand the children their mugs, she finally saw that they both had black eyes. Before drinking any of their cocoa, both children suddenly asked if they could use the bathroom. Trying to keep calm, the woman pointed them in the direction of the bathroom. They passed her husband on the way, and once they had left the room, the husband's nose started to bleed. The power suddenly went out, and when the lights came back on, the children were in the front hallway of the house, staring at the door. The boy said, "Our parents are here." When the husband and wife looked out the front window, they saw a long black car parked out the front of their house, with two men in black coats standing on the pavement. The children then left through the front door, not seeming to care about the snow, and got into the car along with the two men in black coats. The car then drove away like it was nothing, even though it should have been impossible on the heavily snow-covered road. If that wasn't scary enough, a few months after the encounter, the couple's health started to deteriorate. The woman, who emailed the story to the website Weak and Weird, didn't go into specifics, but she claimed that her husband had been diagnosed with a form of skin cancer, and that she herself had been suffering from chronic headaches and nosebleeds. These are just a few of the stories you can find online about black-eyed kids, and reports of the phenomenon have only increased in the past decade. Whether that's because people are making stories up to jump on a trend, or if it's because the popularity of black-eyed kid stories gives people who have seen them the confidence to share their own encounters, We may never know. But if you get a knock on your door tonight and find some kids asking to use your bathroom, don't say we didn't warn you.